AI is quite clearly top of mind for your peers. Is it top of mind for you?
Absolutely, and thanks for having me. AI, I believe, will be the third largest compute revolution that we've seen in our generation. We're going to see from internet to mobile to now AI, the kinds of transformational shifts that happen once in a generation. We're seeing it play out actually right now in real time. I heard your segment earlier today. If you think about the news today from Samsung, think about the dollars at stake with the dominance of search as it relates to AI. $3 billion for Samsung. The big fish, of course, is coming up in the next 60 days with Apple and Google. That's $18 to $20 billion a year to basically be able to get the search results. The question is, if Apple and Microsoft start partnering together, that's a $2.6 trillion company, a $2.3 trillion company. This is really going to be the future of the next decade in technology.
Tell you where also feels like it's the future, Somesh, is regulating it. Too interesting out of Europe at the moment. Many had thought that they would be looking at high-risk AI applications when they were crafting their new regulation. Now people are looking for it to go into general-purpose AI as well. What are you thinking about the regulatory landscape and building into it?
Well, I think it's a great question. I think it's really important to have a balance where we need regulations to make sure that the application layer of AI is used for societal good. I'm a huge fan of making sure that the government authorities work closely with the industry, whether it's large public companies or startups. I also think it's important for potentially thinking about new regulatory bodies that could actually enforce this in a way that's different from traditional internet, software, or mobile enforcement. I think the real question will be, does this actually spur a new generation of mergers and acquisitions for startups and public companies, or will it slow it down, as we saw happen in the consumer sector over the last 5 to 10 years?
Ooh, a bit of M&A and how it'll drive that, Ed. But really, the amount of pitches we get just from founders and VCs wanting to come on and talk about this ecosystem at the moment is phenomenal.
Every single person works in AI now. So it begs the question, how do you play the field? I mean, am I right in saying you must get dozens of pitch decks across your desk every day?
I'd say dozens are an understatement. If you look across the firm, we're getting more than that. I think the most important thing to remember is these are early innings. So what we're actually seeing is the first set of companies that are coming out. It reminds me of GeoCities and Lycos in the early days of the web. We haven't seen the Google equivalents emerge yet. The difference, though, is the pace at which things are happening. ChatGPT got to 100 million users in 2 months. It took Facebook 4 years, Snapchat 3 years, Instagram 2 years to get to 100 million users. GPT-4 feels like old news. It's less than a month out since its general release. And what we're going to see is some of these applications, there's a model in which ChatGPT could get to 1 billion users within 12 to 24 months.
Another big headline that Caroline and I have been discussing of late is the Pentagon and leaks. Discord had a role to play in that. And I believe you were an investor in Discord.
Absolutely, we are, yes.
What do you make of that story? I think it's really interesting because I see all across Silicon Valley, New York, London, VCs putting a lot of money into defense-related startups. But in this case, this is a social media platform that's caught at the heart of this story.
So first of all, what happened was horrible. I mean, the fact that now that there's been an arrest, it's been out in the public that this was a member of the U.S. military who basically took classified documents and shared them on a private chat room, a private server. What ended up happening, of course, though, was they violated two things. They actually shared illegal classified documentation. It's against the law. They broke the law. And they actually violated Discord's terms of service. So when Discord detected this, they worked closely with the federal authorities, with the DOD, to be able to actually stop this. And now that an arrest has been made and more evidence has come to light, it shows the importance of platforms to actually utilize larger trust and safety teams. To tie this back to the previous conversation, though, this is where I think AI has an even bigger role. AI can actually replace human curation and actually enforce not just keywords and triggers, but also context, where in the future, not just words, but images can also be flagged faster, and that could prevent this sort of abuse and illegal activity from happening in the future.
Interestingly, Somesh, of course, when we think about Discord, it was really one of those companies we're expecting to soon enough exit, along with a lot of other key companies. What do you think about these trajectories at the moment? You've talked about M&A in certain areas of AI, but what about exit routes to something like a Discord?
Well, I think for a lot of private companies now, this is really a period about investing in the future. What's exciting is AI actually presents an opportunity to rethink your business. it can actually be a huge accelerant, as we're seeing with Discord. Discord's worked closely. If you think about the biggest AI communities right now, Midjourney and ChatGPT, OpenAI, both are actually on Discord. And if you think about some of the products that Discord itself has introduced, the most exciting for me was one recently that actually creates a summary tool that summarizes all the servers, the users. So if you've left a forum and you want to come back and get a quick, fast summary of what you missed, you have AI as a tool to be able to do that. My own sense, though, is that many of these companies are getting stronger, not weaker, because they're investing in intellectual property, R&D. And in the coming years, these will actually be really big outcomes for Silicon Valley.